Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be walking through the Easter aisles mostly at several different places. This is the Target Dollar Spot, Bullseye Dollar Spot, where almost nothing is a dollar, but some really cute things like these little baskets. There was one that had Easter ears on it, like little bunny ears. You'll see that in a minute. Those were cute. I think they were five for these little bunny jars. I thought that was kind of steep considering Dollar Tree had the Valentine's ones. I'll be curious to see if they get any Easter ones also this year. I don't know what the stuffed carrots for. There's a little bunny basket. It was cute. We've also got several little trays to display things on, like, I don't know, appetizers maybe, boiled eggs, like deviled eggs, colored eggs. They've got these cute Easter towels, more baskets. As you can see, Dollar Spot is very sloppy. Also some, I thought this was so cute, this goose. I put him in my cart, but I didn't end up buying him. They had like ducks and geese, and his little glasses, or her little glasses, were so cute. Little potted flower arrangements and carrots. These little eggs, porcelain eggs. That was like a bunny kit to put bunny prints on the floor for the Easter bunny and like glitter and stuff. More pastel colored spring items. Little gold bunnies for a dollar are cute. I thought those were cute. And then they had some white ceramic ones. Different style little like fabric egg or fabric carrots. And there's a whole bunch of those geese. They've got placemats and towels and springy and Easter colors. And this is, I think that was supposed to be for St. Patrick's Day and kind of like the rainbow colors. And there's a few St. Patrick's Day things there, which I've actually bought quite a bit of at Dollar Tree this year. You'll see that coming up. We got like the egg waffle maker. It's like a little Easter egg shape, little bunny tray. This is not the dollar spot anymore, as you can see. $5 a plate. I mean, they're pretty, but I can't imagine paying $4 or $5 per plate. The little bunny plate's cute though. Mugs, super cute. I like the chick mug. That's super cute. I think those were maybe $5. I'm not sure. I do love the plaid Easter colored like tablecloths and things like that. Those, of course, cost more, but you know, these are better quality, so I could see paying the money for those. Bunnies maybe for a kid's room for those, and these cute little plush springy Eastery blankets with flowers and things on them. And that's for $15. That was really cute. Their wreaths are super cute. The eggs were like yarn. The garland's cute, and I like the basket bunnies made out of like basket weave. Those are super cute. There's like three different styles there. The garland though with the little knit bunnies are very cute. And then I just thought the giant gold egg was cool. It's $12. And then this is some Valentine's Day leftover clearance. I picked up a few things from this, you'll see in my haul at the end of the video. They had a lot of stuff left. We live in an area that's not super populated, so there was actually a decent amount to choose from, including, I don't know if you guys remember this from my other early on Valentine's Day walkthrough, but they had one lamp left that I almost bought at full price. I think it was $10. I ended up getting that for like $2.50, the 75% off. And they had lots of other cute little things. I ended up buying that house too because I didn't have the red one because I didn't want to pay full price for it. And that was a little blanket that you will see at the end too. That's in spring colors. I was able to use it for more than just. Okay, now we're in the Walmart dollar spot. I don't know if all Walmarts have this, or ours just got it not too long ago, but they don't normally have very much good stuff in it. I thought that was really cute, $5. But they do have a few cute things. The salt and pepper shakers. Mugs. I got some of those from the St. Patrick's Day window cleans. Lots of chickens I noticed this year in the Easter section with the plushes. In a minute you'll see chickens also. And I thought that was super cute, that cow or bull or whatever, so cute. Came with candy, but okay, so Walmart has the little birds like Target Dollar Spot does, or Target, I don't know if it's a Dollar Spot anymore. I think they might be in the regular section. I ended up grabbing some more window clings. I thought that basket was cute for $8.88. There was white and tan. And those are paper, and I just thought they were so beautiful. I almost bought some of the rabbit ones with the gold trim. But I got to, you know, for us to have our Easter dinner on, but I got to thinking, like, they don't keep your table. We have a wood table. It gets messed up if you put hot things on it. So I thought, well, that really won't work. So I probably will just use my regular plates. So this, as I'm sure you guys figured out by now, this is the Walmart like regular Easter section. This isn't the dollar section anymore. And I just kind of panned over their plushes. I forgot, but I was going to look for a chocolate scented bunnies. Those are my favorite. I forgot to smell to see if any of them had a scent. I thought that little glittery bunny was cute. And look, there's the chicken or rooster. I guess that was a chicken. They got pigs. Pigs are a big thing right now. I like how those are half like knit. My second oldest daughter loves pig stuff. So if we still bought baskets for the older kids, I would get her that. We have on and off all the way through until just recently we stopped and just get it for the two little kids because the older ones don't live at home anymore. And I don't know how much they want stuffed animals and tons of candy sitting around. So, and now this was my favorite section at Walmart this year for Easter. It's very aesthetically pleasing. If you hear my cats in the background, I'm sorry. They do this. I don't know why. They do it with each other. They sit and like meow really loudly at each other. But anyway, they had some of the prettiest stuff on this aisle. Very reasonable prices too. More gold bunnies, bigger ones. $5. I think that's kind of steep. Those should have been like $3 in my opinion. And there's Finn snoring if you didn't hear that. Oh my gosh. I'm sorry, guys. And then they've got their own version of the jars for $3.98. I think that's a little better. I would pay that maybe. And I love, oh my gosh, Finn. I love this lamb's ear. One, but I think it had eggs in it. If it was just plain, I would have gotten it maybe and added my own stuff to it for different holidays. But I loved this section. The color scheme of this section was so pretty, like the pastel kind of faded colors and stuff. I thought that was so pretty. And I like how Walmart has the like He Is Risen things. They have like a whole set couple sections there just for that. And then they had a couple of little blow-ups. I actually thought about getting one. They're $20 a piece. They had a bunny and an egg. But I might go back and get one. I ended up getting that. It was the last one left. And I think, yeah, it was like less than $5. Then here's their baskets. I just panned over these real quick. They've got pretty much baskets for every type of thing your kid might be into. But, I mean, like, why would you do that in some ways, though? You'd have to buy a new basket, like, every year. pre-filled baskets if you like those. There's one there that's for a baby that's got like a rattle and a plush and a little blanket. I thought that was cute. That's a cute idea for a baby. And it was like decent quality too. Some of their candy. This is like a whole, I was making a comment. I muted myself talking in the background, but it is all Peeps related items, shirts and plushes and candy. And I just don't know. That's so weird to me. Cause I mean, are Peeps that popular? I don't think so. Why does, it's mainly Walmart that goes ape over those. And then now we're on to Hobby Lobby. And there's their jar with the half off. It'd be about $5, right? Or six. I couldn't tell what that price was. I mean, it's not bad for the quality of that, I guess. And they, I thought about getting, not the tablecloth, but they had pillow covers there that were 40% off. There's one right there, I believe. Yeah. And, but it would end up being six, and I have a lot of pillows. And I got to thinking, my pillows are like springy colors, so I don't think I'm going to cover them. We'll see. I might change my mind on that. And there's those birds. Remember the birds? The crows? The black crows that were out for, what was that, Halloween fall time that people went nuts over. They don't seem to be liking the pastel Eastery ones as much because I've seen them every time I've been there. I love Hobby Lobby though. I was telling my husband that the thing I like is that with the half off, their prices are so much more reasonable than most other places for what you get. So I appreciate that they still are. The only thing I would say is someone I was watching was making a comment about, and backed it up with proof, that they can have two of the same item in the store at two different prices. So that's not cool. So be on the alert, paying attention for that, guys, to make sure that you got the lowest price you can get in the store. They are really known for their garlands for any holiday. They've always got the cutest ones. And once again, with the half off, the price is really good. I would have such a hard time choosing if I had to get a garland there. There were so many cute ones. And I probably will go back and get one because I don't have my Easter stuff out yet, but I don't think I've got a garland for Easter. I don't think, yeah, maybe I do though. So we'll see. Lots of wreaths. It turns out there were a lot more of those in a different area of my store. My store was really bad about keeping things organized in the same area. I don't think anyone moved these things either. I just think they split them up and put them in different places. That's probably how they're doing their price. I should have paid closer attention to that while I was there to see if their price was different in the two different areas. Got signs and yard stakes. That little bunny picture's cute. But the yard things like this, those are so reasonable and they make such a cute like statement in your yard, brighten it up. I already have some things, so I didn't get anything. I may go back though once I decorate and see what I've got. If it's not, the stuff will probably be gone. If you guys still hear Finn snoring in the background, I'm very, very sorry. He's on my lap. He is so, so noisy when he snores. Yep. We are actually at TJ Maxx now. I thought about buying that little chick bunny. He was cute for one of the kids for Easter. Lots of garlands, and their garlands were so cute. Oh my goodness. And look at those fake hydrangeas. Those are beautiful. some cute spring stuff for your garden. We said, look, it looks like Finn. It's pretty, like pearly colored egg wreath for $16.99, I think it said. And then we have got their knickknacks, which are always super cute and very reasonably priced also. Those candles, oh my gosh, those candles smelled so good too, but they were $10 a piece. I thought that was kind of steep for an off-brand candle. And the little ducks with the umbrella, so cute. Those little chicks or ducklings, so cute. I end up getting one, you'll see it in my haul at the end, not one of those, but one that was up towards the front of the store. I thought this was super pretty, this cake. It's like made of ceramic and has a bunny on top. But I was like, what does a cake really have to do with Easter though? I just thought that was kind of strange, even though it's pretty. I thought this was really pretty. It's like a candle full, it's like candle succulents. Table runners, very cute. They always have really nice, reasonably priced table runners. But like I said, our table's small enough now, we can't really get one. Traditional ones like that are typically longer than what our table is. And I almost bought this also for one of the kids, but I decided just to wait. And this giant thing, Jamie was like, this is cool. It's probably 4 or 5 feet tall, but it was $100. So guys, I got this magnificent heart lamp on the clearance section at Target. I had actually wanted that when it was full price. I almost bought it, and I'm so glad I waited because it was in the clearance. Look at it. Isn't it so pretty? But it was only $250 on the, I think, with the discount. And then I got... let me turn the light on to show you the rest. So I wasn't going to get this house because, as you guys know, I got the little pink house. But they had the red ones on clearance, and that ended up being $1.50, so I did get it. I'm trying to think what else. I forgot to do like a little haul before I put this stuff away. All right, and I also got this throw. I had seen this, I think it was in the dollar section. Not the dollar section, but the Target dollar spot or whatever, the bullseye dollar spot or whatever. But it is like a really soft material, and it's got these pretty pastel colors. And the thing is to me, I think it works great also for like Easter and spring. So I think this was $250 or something also. So that was a good deal. But this one I just kind of throw because I want all the colors to show. Hey, no, excuse me, Finn. Do not do that. So I just kind of throw it over the end of the chair. But it was the last one. All right. So this is what I got when we were out. You guys got to see what was in TJ Maxx and Hobby Lobby. But from TJ Maxx, we returned something and it was past 30 days. So they had to give us a gift card. So I got this shower curtain for the bathroom. I'm going to be doing a bathroom makeover at some point. I still have to do the kitchen. And this adorable chick. $5.99. Isn't that a great deal? This was $24.99. So that's TJ Maxx with a gift card that we had. And then I got at Hobby Lobby this little basket to go in the living room. I'm going to put, it was $4.99, and I think it might have been half off. I'm not sure if that one was or not. But even if it was $4.99, it's a pretty good deal. This will hold the leashes and things like that. I got these for the kitchen. This was also, I'm not sure if it was on sale, $5.99, and you get 5 of these wood utensils because we're going for that look in the kitchen now instead of, you know, when I do the transformation. And then I thought this chopping block was super beautiful. This is the one that had the most light color in it because it's going to be lighter wood in the kitchen. And this was, well, that's weird. I don't see the tag on it now, but it was really inexpensive. It was like, oh, there it is. It's on the tag, $7.99, and it was half. I believe it was half. No, maybe it wasn't half off, so we might have actually paid $7.99. And then this is from the Dollar Tree. I just thought this was cute. It's a little egg garland. And this was half off. I wanted this last time when I did my Hobby Lobby walkthrough video you guys saw. So I'm getting ready to put this Easter and the St. Patrick's Day stuff up. So you guys will be seeing that soon.